Hello, welcome to AMTv. I'm Colinda, and this is the fourth video in the records management series. In this video, we're going to be discussing folders and metadata. Now, they can both be used in SharePoint, but SharePoint does have the capabilities and the features to tag and use metadata to categorize your information. So I think, why not use that feature? If you're unfamiliar with metadata, let me define that for you first. Essentially, the dictionary definition is data about data or information about information. But an analogy I like to use to best describe it, especially when talking to future users of SharePoint and using it within the system, I use the analogy of a book. Now, a book has a title, an author, a publishing date, number of pages, a genre assigned to it, a little description on the back. All of that information describes the book, it describes the content, and it describes what it's about. So that is metadata. It's information used to describe that book. So we're going to discuss some of the pros and cons of both metadata and folders. So some of the pros of metadata is that, well, you can tag the information in a consistent way. So you can come up with standard columns which contain the metadata that can go across the entire organization, and you would create those in the content type hub. You can also create them for the department to be used for each department and then also used within each library. So you have these standardized terms so you know that the individuals are categorizing documents using the same terminology. So it's a fantastic way to standardize and have a more formal taxonomy to do the tagging with. Another one is that it has greater search and retrievability. SharePoint has a robust search tool and it searches the content as well as the properties. So if you have properties tagged with, say, let's say a document type is often a common form of metadata, and you have report or policy or agenda, and that word is also within the content, that's going to bump up the search results. So that's fantastic as well. And you can also filter and sort things by metadata tags within the library or even just when searching. So again, fantastic way to find things and retrieve the documents easily. Another great benefit is that you can also attach things such as different settings such as policies or workflows or templates to what is called a content type, which is a collection of metadata and these settings to be applied either across all libraries, some libraries, or even just one library. So metadata is a great way to just categorize your information in a more structured and formal way than folders. But it does have its cons. And one of the cons is that it's only as good as the user uses it. So if you don't tag the information, if you don't fill in the metadata fields, then it's not very useful, is it? Another con is that it's quite different. Now, a lot of people are familiar with tagging, using hashtags and stuff like that in social media. And so if you explain it to your users in a sense that, yes, you're just tagging your documents with further information to help categorize it, that may be a way to relate it to them. But to try and get them to understand how metadata works within a library in SharePoint, it can be a bit difficult. Now let's talk about folders, the pros and cons of those. So one of the biggest pros, I believe, within folders is its familiarity. Now, folders are often used traditionally in a hierarchical format across an organization and usually on a file share, like a network drive, shared drive. They may be set up with the best of intentions, and let's say the top folder structure, the top level, is fairly organized. Maybe it's organized by the function of the business or a department, but when you start getting down into those subfolder levels, quite honestly, you lose the logic, you lose the hierarchical structure in the sense that it just becomes, you know, folder upon folder upon folder. So that can be one of the cons to it, is that it can get quickly disorganized. So besides being familiar, they're easy to create. Any user can create them within a library unless that function is turned off. Change management is minimal. And also, you know, less time for training and setup. So some of the cons of folders is that you have the same problems that you did on your shared drive network, just transferred to a different system. Perhaps you have lack of logic in the structure. You have no naming conventions within the folders. You have the ability for any user to just continue to create folders at any level. And you have to remember that within SharePoint Online, you have a character limit within the URL of 260 characters. And if all of a sudden you're 10 folders deep and you've limited to how many characters can be in the title of a document. So you have to be aware of things such as that. As well, another con can just be that managing permissions at a folder level, if needed, can be quite difficult and you want to do it at the library level. So if all of a sudden you have a complex folder structure within one library, managing permissions can get quite difficult as well. Another thing to consider is that items that can be displayed are at about 5,000. And so because each folder is also an item, you limit the number of items that can be displayed within the library, whereas if you're just using metadata, each of the documents is an item as opposed to having a folder too that are adding to the item number. So let me show you some of the features of a library using metadata. I mean, right off the bat, you can see you have some colors here. And that's a feature that was reintroduced earlier this year, that any choice column or date column can be easily color formatted. By using a simple feature that we displayed in actually one of our webinars not too long ago. Not only that though, you can create different views to help you organize the information that's been tagged. So in this library, we have one called document type and the different types of documents. We have, let's say these documents need to be reviewed, so who's going to review them. We have the review date that's been color-coded to show you things that are overdue, up and coming, or are due to be reviewed today. We have a yes or no column. Have these been approved? Yes or no? So you can easily sort and filter by that. And then we also have the department. Whether, you know, who is responsible for this department. So this is the all documents view, which basically shows you all the documents within the library. Now, when you have 50, 100 or more documents, that might be a view, you know, that's a bit difficult to find what you're looking for. But again, using metadata, you can easily sort and filter each of these columns. So let's say we want to filter it by policy. So for an instantaneous, easy way to find all the policy documents, that's very simple. You've just filtered it and boom, there they are in front of you. So that's a very quick, instantaneous way to sort and filter things. But let's say you want a more permanent way to see things. So you can do what's called views, and you create views based on the metadata columns. So for instance, I've created a view based on department. Now this is essentially, it could be compared to folders, because you could have a comms folder, a facilities folder, a finance folder, but the difference with the folders and grouping is in a folder you'd have no idea how many documents are in there unless you open it up. Whereas here in parentheses, you know how many documents are within the comms group. So I click on that little arrow. Oh, and look, I further have organized it into what type of documents are in there. And now I know, again, there's one guideline within the comms department. How about facilities? Look at that. There's one FAQ, there's four guidelines, there's three procedures, and there's one policy. So again, I know right away, well, that's a policy document from facilities. Click on there. And there it is. And that's using the grouped view. But let's say I just want to actually create, okay, I only want to see the documents created by facilities because maybe I work in facilities and that's important to me. Well, there we go. I've created a view for facilities. And right away, the metadata tells me so much information, more than you would find in a folder structure. I know when this document needs to be reviewed, who needs to review it, and whether it was last approved. Can you tell that in a folder structure? No, you can't. Let me show you what you see in folders. You see documents and you see folders. And sure, we have the departments, so we know, okay, right away, documents that are in there are going to be comms related, but we have no idea how many are in there. We don't know what type of documents are in there. We need to go in there and look. Whereas in this library, and the way it was done, we know exactly right away. If I want to filter by comms, There we go. We know I have that one. I know it's a guideline. I don't even have to open it up. Whereas in here, all I have are the titles to go by. And this is typical. Often within a library using folders, you're going to have these loose documents that don't belong in a, or don't go in a folder. People haven't put them in a folder. Or you go into, let's say, the facilities folder. Oh, and then you have some more folders and you got to click on those. Okay, so we have one document in there. One document in one folder, that's over organization. Whereas if you just have it labeled, meeting room setup, that's a guideline, it's with facilities, boom. You don't have to click two or three times to get to that file to know what it is. If I go into finance, okay, so we have 2019, we have accounts payable, we have accounts receivable, we have budget. Okay, so that makes somewhat sense, but what about if 2019 there's some accounts payable or accounts receivable documents in there? Then already you've lost the logic within your hierarchical structure. So metadata allows you to retain the logic because you're labeling it with what you seem or what you feel is logical to it for it to be labeled with or categorized as. Folders and metadata both have appropriate times to be used. So when is that time? Well, personally, I think metadata can be used for pretty much anything you want to organize if you have the appropriate categories and classifications for each of the documents in the libraries. Folders, in a sense, are more appropriate for things such as case files or personnel files, things like that. Those may not be best managed, tagged, and using metadata, but folders would be quite appropriate to contain, you know, all of your employees' files. So in this video, we've discussed some of the benefits, some of the cons to each of them, and when is the best time to use them. It is a decision that needs to be discussed and decided before the onset of implementation, because when you're consulting with your users, you are going to need to decide which is best for them and take into consideration their current work practices, but also the decisions that were made by those who are governing the implementation of SharePoint. So take the pros and cons, weigh them up, and decide which ones you want to use. Thank you for joining us on this fourth video of records management.